at 108. Alright, so it's gonna look like that, then you'll have your building there. I don't know the exact dimensions. And you're gonna have so let's assume this space right here is your garage. Because your garage is on top and the street is along this side, that means you have to cut in from here and then turn. So that means you have to have a radius, a turning radius, and the turning radius is 12 feet. So we'll create a circle with a 12 feet radius. And the next thing is we'll split in four this way. We're just trying to get the arc, and if you want to do it with the arc command, that's fine too. Alright, so now we have this. The next thing is we're going to offset this to 24 foot. We'll move it to that. So now I have my turning radius from a garage. I can bring this down. And this is a minimum 24 foot radius. So that takes cover of like a car coming in and pulling here and then another one coming out. All right, so the next step is I'm gonna explode this. And I'm gonna offset this 5 feet this way. This way, and then the next one is going to be 25 feet, and then my next one is going to be 15 feet. So now this are my setback lines, and I can trim them or do a fillet. And I'm just going to change my line to dash. And for this, I probably have to change the scale to 100. Probably even 200. Even 300. 3000. No. Alright, so I'll just change it to a 300 scale. I don't know how this is going to act when I try to print it, so we'll have to check that. So that's going to change quite a bit. So let's keep it to one. Yep. Keep the scale to one. Or don't even change it. Even if you can't see it here, once you print it, it should show. So don't worry too much about it. So now you have your setbacks, your building footprint. The next thing is you have to create your fence. And that goes along your lot line. You can choose where to put this, but I suggest that since you're using a 4-inch post by 4 inches. So let's say this needs to go right along the edge of your lot line here. And you're going to array this rectangularly. We're going to do one row. Many rows here, one column. We'll just change this to 10. And our space in between is going to be 8 feet 4 inches because it's taking the center. I'll change this to be less rows so I can do 5. And escape. Now I can move this. Explode this. Select them all. And then move this to the corner. What you want to do is you want to keep the consistent number of posts throughout your lines. That way you always end up with a post on the corner. And you might have to play around with this. If for some reason you can't get it to do it here, that's okay. But at least some of them should be consistent. That way you still have a corner. then your fence will flow along this line. And we'll change that, so we'll use the p-edit command. We'll convert it to a polyline. We'll change the width. We might have to mess around with this, but we can start with 116. Won't really be that thick, but it'll be a little thicker. And then we can change that polyline to maybe our heavy. Change it to the heavy. So we might have to play a little bit more with that for you. Feel free to play until you find like something that looks comparable to the example. So that's that. That's all I have to say for the site plan. Really shouldn't be too complicated. And then you'll have to hatch your site plan. We'll use the diagonal hatch, the NC31. We'll have to change the scale to 50, I believe. Let's see, maybe 75. Yeah, 75. So that'll be your hatch. So let's see how it looks here. All right. Then the street name for this, so your lot line is going to be there. Going to offset this 36 feet. If it doesn't show, don't worry about it. So this is going to be the street. We'll have another property here and another property here, and then this will be, we'll do 91st Street. Yep. And you might have to change the scale for this a little. This is too big. Alright, so it'll be 91st. So your lot line will have the sidewalk offset from that, so 6 inches, and then 5 feet. Then you have a curb cut here. So we're gonna see that. And then since this is a contiguous property, we'll just leave it like that. We can always put, no, we'll leave it like that for now. I don't know exactly how the example is.